Does 0.9 repeating equal 1? The two numbers definitely look different, but they do hold the same value, and therefore they are equal. Which means, if we were to plot these two numbers on the number line, they do appear in the exact same location at this point here. And remember, we can also express 0.9 repeating as 0.9 with a bar over the 9, showing the digit of 9 repeats indefinitely. And now let's look at three reasons that show why 0.9 repeating equals 1. Let's begin by considering the fraction 1/3. Let's convert the fraction 1/3 to a decimal. Because a fraction bar means division, 1/3 equals 1 divided by 3, and now let's perform the division to find the decimal form of the fraction 1/3. The pattern continues, which shows 1/3 equals 0.3 repeating, or if we want 0.3 with a bar over the 3. Now that we know the decimal form of the fraction 1/3, let's consider the sum of 3 1/3 in decimal form as well as fraction form. Looking at the sum in decimal form, notice how the sum is 0.9 repeating, which must also equal 1/3 plus 1/3 plus 1/3, which is equal to 3/3, and 3/3 equals 1. This is one way to show 0.9 repeating equals 1, or if we want 0.9 with a bar over the 9 equals 1. And now we'll look at a second reason that shows why 0.9 repeating equals 1 using an equation. To begin, we will let x equal 0.9 repeating, and then multiply both sides of this equation by 10. 10 times x equals 10x. 10 times 0.9 repeating equals 9.9 repeating. So now we have the equation 10x equals 9.9 repeating. So using this new equation and the original equation, we will now subtract x from the left side of the equation and subtract 0.9 repeating from the right side of the equation. 10x minus x, or 10x minus 1x, equals 9x. We have 9x equals, on the right side, 9.9 repeating minus 0.9 repeating equals 9. Solve for x, we divide both sides by 9. 9 divided by 9 simplifies to 1 here and here. This simplifies to x equals 1. Now remember, we started with x equals 0.9 repeating, which once again shows 0.9 repeating equals 1. And now for the third reason why 0.9 repeating equals 1, we will use an infinite geometric series. This is typically a topic in an Algebra 2 or College Algebra course. For any infinite geometric series, if r is the common ratio and the absolute value of r is less than 1, then the infinite sum is given by the formula a sub 1, which is the first term in the series, divided by 1 minus r. So let's first write 0.9 repeating as an infinite series. This 9 represents 9/10. This 9 represents 9/100. This 9 represents 9/1000, and so on. We can write this repeating decimal as an infinite geometric series as 9/10 plus 9/100 plus 9/1000, and so on. And now the value we multiply each term by to get the next term in the series is r, the common ratio. So one way to determine the common ratio is to look for a pattern in the terms. The first term is 9/10, and we can write 9/100 as 9/10, which is the first term, times 1/10, showing we multiplied the first term by 1/10 to get the second term. And then we can write 9/1000 as 9/100, the second term, times 1/10, which shows to find the third term, we multiply the second term by 1/10. This shows that r is equal to 1/10. We can also determine the common ratio r by using the formula given here, a sub n divided by a sub n minus 1, which means we can find the common ratio r by selecting any term in the series and dividing by the previous term. if we use the first and second term, r is equal to the second term of 9/100 divided by the first term of 9/10. Because the fraction bar means division, this is 9/100 divided by 9/10, and dividing by 9/10 is equivalent to multiplying by the reciprocal of 10/9. Simplifying before multiplying, there's 1/9 here and here, and there's 1/10 and 10, and 10/10 and 100. This product is equal to 1/10, which is the common ratio r. And now we can determine the infinite sum, which must equal the repeating decimal, by using the formula a(1) divided by the quantity 1 minus r. Let's do this on the next slide. The infinite sum, which equals a repeating decimal, is equal to a(1), which is 9/10, divided by 1 minus r. So we have 1 minus 1/10 as a fraction, or as a decimal. Let's use the fraction. So we have 9/10 divided by 1 minus 1/10 is equal to 10/10 minus 1/10, which is 9/10. Any non-zero value divided by itself is equal to 1. The sum of the infinite series is equal to 1, which is also equal to the repeating decimal. So once again, we've shown 0.9 repeating does equal 1. I hope you found this helpful.